Hello there, Ali here from Sports Templates. And before we begin today, I just hope that all of you guys are staying home and washing your hands and staying safe until we get through these hard times we're living. Hopefully, this is gonna end soon and we're gonna get back to our regular life. Till then, we gotta keep doing what we're doing. And today, I'm bringing you guys a new template that received the most votes last month on our new voting page on our website. And you can find it here. You can find the link in the description below, and you can go right now to vote for which template you want to see next. So here we just share with you all the templates that we're working on currently. We have more than 25 templates that are under development, and every month we're going to see which template receives the most votes, and that's what we're going to release. Some of them are still under development. This is why we're using regular pictures. Like for this Jumbotron, we just used a regular image. These are under development currently. And for this month, everyone voted for this sports waving flags mock-up pack template. And this is what we ended up doing. So in this template, you're gonna get three different mock-ups. You're gonna get this stadium waving flag. You're gonna get this flat flag on a table or floor that has regular flag fabric here. And then we also have an extra layer where you can add your logo or extra parts of the flag where it's in this shiny satin fabric look. So you can combine two materials on the same flag. We also have a huge wall flag. This is perfect if you want to put a player, or you want to put like a whole team, and you want to composite them into a scene. We're just giving you a scene where you can change the flag on the wall back, and you can also add any graphics or designs to the floor as well. So we tried to use three different types of flags: a standard flag that's flat on the floor, and then a big version of a flag like this that goes across a huge wall, and then we have a standard flag that people would use, that people will fly at a football game or a basketball game. And the new thing in these templates is that we're using a new 3D layer, which is actually wrapping the graphics in a physically accurate way. So you can see that this grid is actually moving with the fabric. Usually we fake it. We try to fake this effect with smart objects. This time we don't have to. It's actually moving accurately with the model. This is a new feature in some of the recent Photoshop versions. The most stable one is Photoshop CC 19. This is what I would recommend using this one. I wouldn't recommend using Photoshop 20 because it has a lot of bugs. So if you're using Photoshop 20, you might wanna just downgrade to Photoshop 19 if you wanna use the 3D effect. If you don't have Photoshop 19, if you have any other version that doesn't support 3D, or you don't wanna deal with a 3D object, you still can use the 2D wrap, which is a simpler one. This is where we're trying to mimic the actual 3D mapping. So this is how the 2D layer would look, and this is how the 3D layer would look. It's a little bit more realistic. It looks a little bit more wavy because it's actually just reflecting how the geometry of the flag is done when we did the whole 3D model. So if you're looking for something more streamlined and you don't want to displace your graphics or logos a lot, you can just go with a safe bet, which is the 2D mapping. And if you want to do something more realistic, I'd recommend you go with the 3D mapping. This goes for all mockups. Each one has a 2D version in purple here and a 3D one in yellow. Same thing goes for this mockup as well. So for today's tutorial, I'm going to be doing this University of Michigan flag using the waving flag template, and it's gonna be super easy because I've already included a few flags in the template. So usually with a 2D smart object, we can just double click on the thumbnail like that and it opens the smart object where we can add our designs. With 3D, there's one extra step that we need to do, which is we need to click this small arrow here, which opens the 3D properties. And then we need to go to add your flag here with the little eye icon here and double click on this text. Now this is gonna open the 3D texture layout. Once you open the 3D texture, you're gonna see this UV mesh layout here, which is basically showing us how the polygons in the 3D model of the flag are laid out. This pretty much works exactly like a smart object, All you need to do is turn off the grid, which we included, and now you can pick from any flag we included here. So you can have the three horizontal stripes flag. So this is flags like Germany, Russia, the Netherlands. You can have vertical flags like Italy, Ireland, Belgium. We also included the Canadian flag, the US flag, and the UK or the Union Jack flag. Each of these flags include separate layers, so you can change colors and everything is in Vector, so you can scale it up and down however you want. And since this Michigan University flag uses the American flag as a base for the design, we can just turn on the American flag here and work from here. So here we have the stars and everything separated. So I've already made this library with this tutorial, so I'm gonna include a link to this library in the description below, so you can get the colors and the Michigan University logo here. So all I have to do is just hide this top left, hide the stars, make the background blue, make the stripes yellow, and then drag this M logo, line it up with the stripes here, and put it here. Let's take a look. I think we need to have a bigger space here. Since this is all vector graphics, you can just go select the stripes, go to the direct selection tool, and then just select these vertices alone and shift drag to the right just to give us an extra space here. We can also move the M a little bit to the right. These markers show you where the pull of the flag is, so if you don't want the graphics to be on the pole, you can just make sure that they are inside. And this is pretty much it. You just save it from here. Control S to save. Go back to our design. Just need to hide the 2D layer. And there we go. I have this atmosphere layer on top, so you can turn it off if you don't want extra lights in the scene, and turn it on however you want. So if we zoom in, we can see how this looks super realistic, because our design is just it's just being displaced using a 3D model, a 3D layer, which is something that's not possible with regular mockups and templates, since we're just using this new technology with a 3D texturing in Photoshop. So if you go to Shutterstock, for example, and you look for an American flag, you can see that the author who made this image, they just laid out a flat American flag on top of this image, and they just did a little bit of distortion here and there, but you can pretty tell it's fake and it doesn't look realistic because you have all these folds, but the actual flag is not conforming to these folds, and it doesn't look like it's a real, it just looks off even to the untrained eye. This is the same thing with all these images of the flags. These authors, they just take a picture of a white cloth and they just do like an overlay with an American flag on top of it. What we're giving you here is a tool that you can just generate a lot of images, and all of them are going to look realistic, and they all kind of look like they are part of the flag and they're not just not like Photoshopped on top of it. I think this was like the fastest tutorial I've done on this channel. So we have a little bit more time to just play around with the rest of the templates. So for example, if we go here, let's say we want to do the Union Jack flag. We can just go to the 3D layer, go all the way down to this 3D object layer, and we just need to add logo here. Double click. And this is just controlling the satin part of the logo of the flag. So let's turn on the Union Jack and let's hide everything else. I just want to keep the red stripes, for example. Let's Control S to save. Now moving on to the base, select the 3D layer here and click on add your design here. Double click. Turn on the Union Jack and just hide the red parts. Control S to save. And now we have a British flag that looks super realistic and premium. So if you zoom in, you can see that the base parts are using the the basic texture of the flag, and then the red bars are using this satin high quality look. You can even change the background color. So we can go with something like this, or maybe like a black background, or get colors from the flag. And this works for any type of flag or design. You can just put it here and it's gonna work perfectly. Now moving on to the last template. Here we have a floor layer and we have the flag layers. So I have the 2D flag and the 3D flag again. So select the 3D flag and then add your design here. Maybe we can add the Italian flag here. Since these layers are all vectors, so we can just double click and change colors to any flag we want. So if we do Control S to save, you can see that the flag works great with it. You can see all these distortions, they're being realistic. And then the same thing goes for the floor. If you don't need to add any graphics, we just hide this layer and then we control the floor color. So if you need like a black floor like this, and this is perfect if you want to put like a soccer ball here or football team or any kind of design. This is a perfect backdrop for your design. Of course, everything is editable here. So if you go to the effects folder here and you just scroll down all the way, you can go to base shadows. Let's say you need your design needs a more dark look, you can just increase the shadows and it's going to start looking more, the shadow's going to start looking be more intense. Same thing goes something like this. Same thing goes for the floor. So you can just go to floor effects and then just go base shadows, just darken it like this a little bit. Or if you need extra reflections, you can just go to reflections, Control J to duplicate, and now everything's a little bit more reflective. And of course everything is using the dynamic lighting feature, so you can just turn it on or go inside here and just work with these sliders to get the perfect lighting situation you need for your scene. Of course this is included in all the templates, so you can add it here as well. And on this waving flag, you can just go in and do the exact same thing, change how the light hits it, and then control how intense it is from the channel mixer. And also you have this atmosphere layer which has some bokeh effect kind of reflecting from the lights in the background that you can turn on and off. Also we have this glare from the lights in the background, so you can turn on or off. And one last thing I want to talk about is the background here. You can basically change the colors of the advertising boards in the background to kind of fit with your design. So if you go to Adds Banner Color here and double click, go to Master and then select blues, so I can drag it all the way to the edge here, get something yellowish. Then we can just drag down the lightness a little bit and crank up the saturation. Then we can go to cyan, do the same thing and make it a little bit saturated. And now you can see that it kind of fits better with the background. Here's before and after. Also, if you don't want a color, if you don't want any colors in the background, you can just turn off this layer and just go and turn on the atmosphere and just go for a muted background layer like this. It's up to you. I hope you guys like this template. Let me know if you want to see more templates like this, and looking forward to see what you guys can do with this template, and see you guys in the next one.